This is a Quaker story about some of the ways friends describe God's image or God's presence. God comes to each of us in different ways and at different times. Maybe you already have an image of your own. Or maybe you're not sure you have an image of God at all, or even need one. Sometimes God is simply an unseen presence. But God is all around us and in us. We listen deeply with our whole selves to know the divine. There's mystery in the things that we know are there, but we cannot see. One of the ways friends experience God is as light. Light that helps us see truths inside us. Light that warms us in the world around us. A source of energy that's always there for us. An inner light that helps guide us. And a fire that burns with truth. God can be like the light that illuminates what we know is true inside us. Sometimes friends think of God as breath or air. Breath, like God, is sometimes invisible to our eyes. In many languages, the name for God is the same word used for breath or air. In Latin, the word is spiritus. God can be like this too. Another way friends think of God is as like water, a pure, clear spring of water, or perhaps a deep, deep well that never runs dry, water that is life-sustaining, water that satisfies our thirst, and without which we cannot live. God can be like this too. Sometimes we say, God is love. Love without end. Love without conditions. Love that connects us to one another and to all of creation. Love that heals and makes forgiveness possible. God can be like this too. Sometimes friends think of God as an inner guide, like a compass. A compass which helps us find our path and stay on course. A compass that always points true north, so we can always find our way. God can be like this too. There are many images of God as a person. Here's just a few that come close for some people. God is like the most loving parent imaginable. God is like a shepherd, watches over the sheep. God is like a builder, who can create something from nothing. God can be like this too. God can be like these images and so many, many more. There are more images of God than we could ever count. And each of them helps us know some small part of God. I don't know what might go here for you. It may change many times during your life, and that's okay. God is all around us and in us. We listen deeply with our whole selves. We use our minds and our imaginations and our hearts. And in the mystery of what we cannot see, we can still know God's image in so many ways. Now, I wonder which part of this story you like the best. And I wonder which part of this story you think is the most important. I wonder how these images feel for you. And I wonder what might go here for you. Now, friends, I wonder what your work will be today.